Hello, you malty, marvellous malt moments. And thank you to Domino55 for that malt mention. Introducing Whisky Review 441, which today, at this moment of recording, in the Manx Bothy, is a Scotch single malt whisky called Benriach. It's a little bit unusual. It's triple distilled. Very few Scotch single malt whiskies are triple distilled. That is more a feature of Irish whisky. But generally, when Scotch whisky is triple distilled, that is to say, just to explain, that it gets put through pot stills three times instead of twice, resulting in a higher alcoholic strength final product, or claret new make spirit, which happens to be a little bit more refined than your double pot stilled whisky. Of course, the holy grail of distilling accomplishment is single pot distillation. We don't see much of that, although it can be done. Anyway, back to this. It's not that long out in the market, so you may be able to pick up a bottle fairly readily wherever you are, if you have availability of Benriachs. They're quite a mixed bunch in this family. It's a big range within Benriach of peated and unpeated single malts, and they do vary considerably, by the way. You do get a common personality, but it's very variable depending on its production and maturation, and this is no exception. This, incidentally, is bottled at cask strength. It's 15 year old. It's been matured in a Pedro Ximenez. Anyway, listen to me like I know what I'm talking about. Pedro Ximenez, there we go, sherry puncheon. And this, for you malt anoraks who want specifics, is cask number 7633. Now, you'll notice I've actually poured two glasses of this single malt. The glass over here, I poured half an hour ago and added about 20% water. So over a, almost a fifth of the volume was water added to this. And I'm going to explain why shortly. But first of all, the smell, the taste, the malt mark. Clearly sherry, brown sugar, a little bit of dark coffee, and distinct fusel notes that you encounter in the likes of young Avengerics from Lewis and young Ben Nevis's. Seems quite sweet and sour, intense, wood heavy, pineapple jam, Coca-Cola. Well, not Coca-Cola, cola. I won't be too specific. It's not something I really buy. Well, not for myself. I'll buy for visitors who are insisting on it. But it's a brand I avoid, personally. Spiced chocolate. Wood sap. Cherry lozenges. Bitter wood. See, there's a kind of wood theme coming into the nose here, definitely. Sour tea. And boiled wood sap. Distinctly fusel. When I first tasted this, by the way, it reminded me of what it must be like to drink a glass of plywood. Literally, plywood. Incredibly wood heavy, very immature tannin rich, quite fusel. For 15 years, it's strange, there seems relatively little maturation going on here. It's an oddity, this. It's a strange one. Do not give this to beginners or people who don't drink Scotch whisky. A glass of this would probably put people off for life, in my opinion. This is quite raw, intense, hugely wood rich. In fact, it reminds me of Wiseman's American whiskey, where they literally pour the spirit through wood chips, toasted wood chips. Goodness knows, when you're talking about a Pedro Ximenez puncheon cask being used, I am not getting your traditional experience of a Pedro Ximenez puncheon cask at all. It's perhaps a new made Spanish oak cask, or perhaps an American oak cask, which has contained Pedro Ximenez sherry. But personally speaking, going solely on what I'm experiencing in smell and taste, I really don't think that sherry cask was used for actually maturing sherry long term. I have to quantify what I'm saying here by saying it's a personal opinion, by the way. I'm not giving you facts, I'm giving you opinions, and I want you to be aware of that. So the first thing we've got to really do is add water. Most important, quite a lot of water. Improves it immediately, but still very sour tea, wood sour, fusile. 15 years going on 8. As for triple distilled, with triple distilled you get refinement, you get light complexity. You're not getting that here. Goodness knows, I mean, if you were to present to this to me on the glass without telling me that it was triple distilled, I would never in a month of Sundays associate this with a triple distilled spirit. Simply no way. So I don't know if they simply rushed the spirit through the stills, fearful that they might lose the character of Benriach. But to be honest, I don't even see the point of saying it was triple distilled. But that's a personal opinion. Now, I've lifted up the glass, by the way. You'll see the scotch mist developing in this glass because it's cask strength. It's an unchill filtered whiskey. Thank goodness. Nose. Oops. I've just spilt it down my trousers. Oh, dear. What a terrible waste. The nose has subdued considerably, but it's also softened a lot as well. It's much more an old school, aged floral Benriach. The fusile note has subsided considerably. The sour tea note has all but disappeared. You're getting that soft brown sugar, a lovely rounded but still kind of youngish Benriach. As an experience, this is not a whiskey I would recommend to the occasional malt drinker. This is a whiskey which I would recommend to someone who drinks single malt whiskies that is prepared for a challenge. And that, of course, is reflected in the malt mark. 83 out of 100. It's a malt mark. Incidentally, the finish, once it's sat with some water in it for a while just to settle down, I was actually tempted to basically decant this whiskey to oxygenate it, to kind of break down some of that edginess to it. Much more appealing given a bit of time with a lot of water. Brown sugar in the finish, some gentle soft sour wood, and some slightly overbrewed tea. So the negatives when you first encounter this whiskey, they do subside as the spirit itself exerts itself, re-exerts itself over time when the presence of water. It needs to be done, really. the whisky really is saved by the substantial character of Benriach. If it was a slighter signature of malt, this would not probably be getting reviewed. But the character of Benriach does come through successfully. And as I say, improves hugely after 20 minutes with about 20%, not just a few drops of water. Really, you want to be adding quite a bit of water to this. It's very reminiscent of an immature sherry cask. And I'm going to come back to that a little bit, because it's when you have experience of tasting whiskey from a sherry cask, which was never broken down into its staves and was originally constructed for the long-term maturation of sherry, not just for the temporary storage of sherry or the rinsing with sherry, then you could claim it was a sherry cask, and then you could sell it on for considerable profit to the whiskey producers, such as the demand for these. I would suggest, by the way, if you're looking to buy sherry casks, you'll notice that the fashion has switched from Oloroso at the moment to Pedro Ximenez. These are big, bold, generally sweet, intense sherries. But there are other sherry casks out there. There's Amontillado sherry casks. There's Fino sherry casks. These are styles of sherry which are lighter. The Amontillado is very nutty, quite complex, one of my favourites. And of course, there's Palo Cortado, which is really a style of sherry named after the grape variety, which is predominantly used for the manufacture of quality sherries. And but you see, with the fashion at the moment in the Scotch whisky industry, it's for Pedro Ximenez and Oloroso. And the simple reason is they want that big sherry hit, which you can get from short-term engagement with these casks. Whereas with Fino sherry, Amontillado, you can get most beautiful, exquisite sherry-matured whisky results. But it takes longer, takes more time and commitment. And perhaps that's something that the whisky industry should be mindful of, that people know about these things. People are understanding these things like never before. And now is the moment for those precious principles: quality control. Quality, quality, quality. I hope you'll join me again soon for Whisky Review 442. It'll be another Benriach, by the way. We're doing a double dunt here, but a very, very different Benriach. Nothing like this one. See you soon, malt mates.